Hey, the BUS-eum is coming back to Spencer, and I had forgotten this factoid that it actually bases out of Spencer. We have the director here, Dr. Michael Luick-Thrams. You're back in town. You're back in the country.
Yes, I'm glad to be back.
When can we see the BUS-eum, and what is the topic this time around?
Normally, our exhibits have always been historical, Iowa social history, sort of the pioneer days to the end of the Second World War. But this time we have a history exhibit in the bus, but outside we have a contemporary exhibit about climate change. Indeed, I live in Germany at the moment. I'm teaching at the Universität Erfurt, which is between Leipzig and Frankfurt. And so a dozen of my students will be here in waves over the next 3 months, starting in Spencer on Friday, Emmitsburg on Saturday. We'll be going to Nebraska, Missouri, Illinois, Minnesota, Wisconsin, perhaps the Dakotas, and our students will be talking about a thing they call Heartland's future, how do we live together on a shifting planet.
Let's meet a couple of your students that are in the United States right now. Bruno, I'm going to have you introduce yourself to my audience. What's your full name and where are you from? Where do you study?
I'm Bruno Ronnie Fischer. I'm from Germany, from the middle of Germany. I'm not studying right now. I'm studying probably at the end of the year. I was doing some tourist guidings, and that's how I came in contact with Michael. And then, I was asked to go to the U.S. with him, and I said yes.
What have you seen so far in this country?
I've seen a lot of fields. Also, I've met a lot of nice people. We were with Quakers, with Jews, with members of the Episcopal Church and of the Unitarian. A lot of nice towns. It sometimes really explodes my mind that this whole country is like so new, so fresh, and just is like every building is like dropped from a printer onto the surface.
Yes. Have you been to any big cities?
We have been to Minneapolis, St. Paul.
And when do you go home?
I will leave the U.S. in mid of June.
And then what will you study this fall?
Probably dental medicine.
Oh, well, good luck to you.
Thank you.
David, welcome to Spencer, Iowa. Welcome to KICD.
Hi, thank you so much.
What's your background and your name?
I'm actually a student with Michael. My name's David Bernhardt. I'm studying international relations at the University of Erfurt. And I've been working on this project on the BUS-eum for almost 6 months now, even maybe a bit longer, right? Since what's that? November, October, something like that. And we've been preparing a climate change exhibit. And the main focus is that we are basically looking for or to spur discussions, discourse on climate change. So we have a little exhibit, but you are welcome to come down to the various locations that you can find on our website as well. And take a listen to our presentations. And afterwards, we're happy to engage with you and talk about solutions and things, how we can solve the climate crisis and how we can take action together.
And how long are you staying?
I'm staying for 2 months. I'll be gone in May. I'm enjoying my time so far and really happy and grateful to be here.
Have you visited other parts of the country?
I have. I'm actually flew in from New York. So I've spent a few weeks in New York before. It's quite a change to come from a big bustling city like that down here to the Midwest. It's been quite a change. But I have to say the people are here much nicer. You notice the difference. There's a shift in just the kindness that you see every day.
David and Bruno, so glad you stopped by the radio station. Hope you enjoy the rest of your time here in the United States. Michael, remind me, there are some local sponsors that make this whole BUS-eum possible.
Yes, we couldn't do this, of course, without our main sponsor, John Vanderhaeg, here in Spencer with satellite offices around the Midwest. And Joey DeBoer at VTech Science has been very helpful. Literally, we just left his studio where we've been cutting the new panels. The students have actually designed the new panels. And our website for more information is heartlandsfuture.com. That's Heartland with an S, heartlandsfuture.com. And if you want to see about the historical exhibit, which would be an inside, that'd be rather www.traces, like the outline of something, traces.org.
Michael, when your students in Germany find out that you're from the United States, what do they ask you about our country?
Oddly enough, the university administration wants me to teach in English, so I do. I could do it in German. And the students, mostly we focus on German-American relations 1933 to 48. We talk about including the Algona POW camp. We talk about the 90,000 American I actually Midwest POWs kept in German camps. So my students learned a lot about Germany and America during World War II and that special relationship. Every third Iowan has German ancestry. In the Midwest, it's also very high. Out in the Dakotas and Wisconsin, it's much more, half, or in some parts of the Midwest, three-fourths of the population. So we're always pleased to focus on German-American relations because this is a very rich relationship, a rich history, and it's ongoing. I bring students to the Midwest. I also will be taking Midwest students to Germany. I teach in the middle of the country in Germany, and we would welcome interns. And in fact, it's not that difficult to actually study in Thuringen for a semester or a year. It's easier than people would think.
The BUS-eum starts that trek in Spencer at the Clay County Heritage Center on Friday, then on to Emmitsburg on Saturday.